Peter has a question here. In 13.32, pond walls, the short animation discusses where to best apply clay. If it is in short supply, would such a tamped clay cutoff work if the other earth involved is mostly sand? How low does the clay percentage of the soil need to be for you to consider using this method? How much of the wall does the core need to be? The whole width of the key? 10% of the thickness of the wall? A third the thickness of the wall? Well, on this dam that was built in 2002, the key was about as wide as this wall. And it was as it was deeper than the roof of a 27-ton bulldozer. So it was 2.5 meters probably deep at the base of this wall. And we had enough clay. But if you were short of clay, you might move it over so most of the clay is on this side. That side of the wall can be poor material, and that could be quite sandy and shaley or rocky. So the worst material goes on the outside, the better material comes in the core and the inside slope. If you're really short of material, you move the core right over. So the core of the wall going down to the cutoff, going down to the key weight is mostly on this side. And it's almost like a laminated wall down that inside there. And you really want to pack it down. You'd like 30% clay in that material at least. If you start getting less than that, possibly you should think about incorporating a sealing material like bentonite. You know, because you can, it's cheaper to include it in the construction. And if you still have a problem, then you might go ahead with bentonite and the material. And if you can fill the dam, you can then try one of these new polymers that have been very successful. And you don't have to re-earthwork the dam construction. The earthworks doesn't need to be addressed or reshaped if you're using a polymer. But if you come in afterwards and you want a bentonite, then you've got to strip off a foot of subsoil or top, usually subsoil underneath where the water line is, put that to one side, lay out your bentonite so it's all white right across the dam, and put 1 foot of topsoil back on, 300 millimeters, and compact that down. And ideally fill it up then, or if you can't, wait for rain. So it's not just a matter of putting bentonite in. If you really have trouble, you've got to actually lay out the bentonite after stripping off 300 mil or foot of topsoil and then put that back. And that can't have any big rocks or stones in it. So there is an advantage to using a polymer because there's you don't have to pay the extra for the earthworks. But if you're in doubt as you're building, it's definitely cheaper to include the bentonite in the initial construction phase because your earth movers work in there and can incorporate it in the construction process. So it's a matter of making a judgment call in construction to pay that little bit more to get some bentonite into the constructed compacted material if you think you're deficient. So here's some polymer. One of these buckets will cover 10 meters by 20 meters the surface area of a dam, like this one behind me. And it's like a crystal. Right. And it's a crystal that when it hits the water, it swells up like a snowflake and sinks to the bottom. This material here is called seep. The model they produce called seep, which does a gradual seeping leak. There's another product called plug, where you've got a much larger leak. So we're gonna treat this dam here. We've had it assessed. They don't think the leak is in the tail end. They think it's in the deep end near the dam wall. So we're going to go 20 meters by 10 with one bucket and 20 meters by 10 with another bucket, drop it in, draw down the polymer and snag it all up. This is Polymer Innovations, the company's called, and that's 19 kilos there. And it's been very successful. People have reported that it works very well. So we're gonna give it a try because we've got a good test case there with the dam behind me.